We're trying to restore the relationship of ego to the other components of the psyche that existed as recently as 12,000 years ago. The ego has become a deadly growth in the historical societies, exacerbated by the phonetic alphabet, monotheism, modern science. This is like you're getting sicker and sicker and sicker as you lay these things on. And so the idea is that if we could restore the original diminished role of the ego that it had for that period, however long it was, that we could begin to solve our problems. Because the problems which face us, put very simply, are going to demand sacrifice. And sacrifice is what the ego doesn't want to hear about. I mean, when you go to somebody and say, look, to save this planet, we're going to have to redistribute income radically. That means everybody in this room is going to have less. We're going to have to honor a whole bunch of cultural positions that we previously just were going to bulldoze over, and so forth and so on. So it's the diminishing of ego by any means necessary that lies to getting any grip on our problems. I mean, if we continue as we are, I think we have probably less than 30 years before life is irreconcilably screwed up. You know, nobody believes that the future is rosy and wonderful. I mean, if you go to the people at the World Bank and the IMF and these people who are straight, you know, suits, all of them, they have a set of curves which would stand your hair on end. When they propagate the curve of population, the curve of toxification of the environment, the curve related to the ozone hole disappearing, you see, you know, it's finished in sometime in the next 50 years. They don't talk about this because they don't want to panic the vast numbers of people who just go to work and raise their kids and pray somebody smarter is doing something about all this. But they don't believe there is any kind of normal future. And I don't either. I think we're going to, that it's business as usual is not on the menu, folks. We're either going to go into an era of immense resource scarcity, regimentation, governmental interference in our lives, tremendous propagandistic efforts to make us do one thing or another, or we're going to pull the plug on scientism and its stooges and the institutions which feed us, feed it. Capitalism is an interesting problem, more easily discussed now that communism is out of the picture. Capitalism is as anti-human a philosophy as you can possibly conceive, because at this very moment we should be consuming less, manufacturing less, selling less, transporting less. And what's the battle cry? Free trade everywhere. What does free trade mean? It means my right to come to your country and sell the most outlandish junk you've ever seen, and you will have no right to turn it away, because in the name of free trade, crapola has to go everywhere. It's really, see, they try to tell you that capitalism and democracy are not at variance. Actually, the whole Marxist-Leninist socialist thing was a side dish. The real life and death struggle is between capitalism and democracy. Democracy says everybody has an innate worth that must be honored. Capitalism says those who die with the most toys win. You cannot reconcile these two things. And nobody wants to talk about this. We're still having the party over the fall of communism. But, you know, you go to the Soviet Union or the former areas of the Soviet Union and you see that what it was a deep freeze for traditional culture. In Kyrgyzia and Turkmenistan, people are basically camel husbandry is what's going on. now, with communism on the rocks, McDonald's will be there in 5 years, and Kmart will be following close behind. So I think we're coming to a great crisis of fundamental, our relation to our own fundamental institutions. I'm not anti-capitalist. I think capitalism needs to sever its connection to materialism. This is, again, why virtual reality is interesting. You sell things made of light, not made of beryllium, metal, brass, steel, and wood, but light. We've got all the light we need, but we have to stop making things out of stuff, or we're not going to be around to tell the tale.
Your model has been that everybody in the culture participated in this and were able to shift their values simultaneously so to cooperate. Are you suggesting, is that the necessary outcome in this case?
No, I think that, you know, revolutions are made by percentages. If 15 or 20% changed, then the example would spread. You see, we are not, psilocybin is the easy way to awaken. You know, take a psychedelic plant and have an experience and get your act together. But the future is full of sledgehammers. It's not going to end with a whimper. It's going to end with a series of thuds and bangs. It could begin almost any time. I mean, we could get a hot, muggy day in Mexico City this summer, and a million people would die. This thing in Los Angeles is a wake-up call. It is going to get uglier and more chaotic and more crazy. There is going to be more starvation, more fascism, more dictatorship. It's unless we do something, until we do something. And it can, how bad is it going to have to get before people say, you know, we're doing something wrong? You know, people dance on the Russians, but you've got to admire people who have the guts to say, we did it entirely wrong, 100%. I mean, can you imagine in this country to being able to do, say, you know, I mean, it may be coming. This character from Austin is a peculiar item in the mix. You know, I mean, I for years had a fantasy speech, which I always imagined that I would somehow end up giving, but it's the speech where you say, my fellow Americans, you have been lied to, screwed, and abused by these two criminal parties for 100 years. And your only hope is to overthrow the Republicrats and create a decent world to live in. Well, no Republican can make that speech. No Democrat can make that speech and be credible. It has to be somebody who wasn't in bed with either of those forces. So I'm not at all pleased by who apparently will bear the mantle. But on the other hand, if change is what we need, then it's probably not going to be a candidate that you and I can embrace. It's going to be some oddball. So, you know, we have to recognize it when we see it coming. Yeah.